Test.
Hi, everyone. It's really great to be here. I'm Adrian, working for Telenav. I'm here to share with you how Telenav is using machine learning to generate information for the maps using sensor data and imagery. I think many of us have made at least one OSM edit in the past, knowing the necessary process to do it. Today, I want to share with you a different and more enjoyable and efficient way to do that. A short introduction of me. I'm a guy who strives to bring machine learning benefits into practical applications like this one. Let's start by letting you, for a few moments, read this code quietly. I like it very much because it expresses in an elegant way the challenges we are facing towards a better and continuously changing OSM app. And because many of us know already how OSM edit works, I want to offer you, again, a different and elegant way to do that. And for that, let's discuss a bit about our goal. Some time ago, we have asked ourselves, which is the most efficient way to improve the OSM? And our response was to make use of the sensor data and imagery for that. Let's see a visualization of our response, which became the goal. Here we can imagine a system capable to automatically detect the changes on the map based on sensor data and imagery collected on the roads. On the picture is an example of change speed limit and the new stop sign automatically detected on the random road. So we have just defined the goal. It remains to find the best way to reach it. For that, we have identified the following five steps. Detecting objects of interest in the pictures, mainly traffic signs, geo-positioning the detected traffic signs, aggregating detections from multiple steps of the same trip and from multiple trips, comparing aggregated detections with OSM, assessing with if that sign already exists on the map. If not, easily edit with OSM with only one click. Let's start with the first step, which is detecting traffic signs from the pictures. For that, I've just picked a random trip from Detroit, from OpenStreetCam, which, by the way, is our platform for collecting images. Here we can visualize the traffic signs like speed limits, do not enter signs, stop signs, and so on. In total, almost 100 cases, different type of traffic signs. It's important to note that often the same traffic sign is detected in several successive pictures of the same trip from different positions of the car. On this slide, there are some technical details about how we did that. As a method, we use, of course, machine learning, which is some kind of standard of today. As algorithm, we use deep learning for object detections, mainly RetinaNet. As data set, we had almost 100K manually labeled pictures containing almost 200K manually labeled and validated detections. All of them containing 98 different traffic signs, or classes, how we call them. Here I can make a parenthesis telling you that we also use a machine learning algorithm in order which is able to assess the quality of the image. If the evaluated quality is below a certain threshold because of various conditions like night, weather, and so on, we skip it as a back picture. Regarding how the algorithm performed, we arrived to a precision of 97% with a recall of 96% roughly. Those are the traffic signs we are detecting. We are in, until this step, we have for each picture, it's detected with traffic signs. And the geoposition of the picture, which was collected from OpenStreetCam. It's time to go ahead to the second step, which is geoposition of the detected traffic sign. And for that, let's visualize our trip in JASM on top of OSM. Here we have the trip marked in blue and the vertical arrows indicating the position where the pictures were taken. On the bottom right, in the JASM, is the current picture focalized in JASM. Big blue circle and blue arrow indicate the position where the picture was taken, the current picture. Also, we can notice that the same traffic sign is visible from multiple pictures of the same trip. And the geoposition of the traffic sign is not the same as the geoposition of the picture, as expected actually. Means that we have to determine the geoposition of the traffic sign, but how we can do that? We all know that any far positional object looks smaller. Using this idea, we'll calculate the geoposition analytically based on existing relation between object size, the size of the object in the picture, and the distance to the object. This gives the distance. The angle to the object from the car direction can be very easily inferred. Therefore, based on this angle and the distance to the object, the traffic sign can be pretty easily geolocated. Some details about how we do that are on the slide. We can find all input parameters we have used, the output and the average positioning error. The third step would be to aggregate the geopositional traffic signs, and let's explain how we solve that. For that, let's start visualizing the set trip which we already used to. First on street using satellite view. On the map showing detections from one trip. On the map showing detections from multiple trips. And on the map showing detections from all trips. Selecting only one speed limits, if we select only the speed limits, 30 in this case, we can visualize the output in the pictures on the screen. We can notice a group of agglomerated speed limits, 30. All of them can be grouped, and the center of the group will indicate the position on the map for that traffic sign. Also, we can be more confident that the position is a good detection. Same for traffic lights, visualizing also the center of the traffic lights group. So it's important to, I think here to say again that we are talking about one physical traffic sign and one physical speed limit. Okay. And in the end, let's visualize only the center of the groups which formed. It's important to note here that the little black arrows, on the icon, because it has a meaning. And we can see that it has different orientations. Those indicates the rotation angle of the sign, or its facing angle, how we call it. In this example, we have two traffic signs and two turn lanes, each one referring to one direction of the road. We call this process aggregated traffic signs. For those interested in some details, the slide shows them. Worth to mention that we determine group of signs, technically named being the clusters. And for that, we are using far more features besides road traffic signs geolocations. Detected cluster centroids will be our final detected traffic signs. And Only those final results will compare in the next step with the OSM. On the fourth step, we are doing a comparison of the final estimated detection with the OSM, deciding whether something has to be added on the map or not. We call this step OSM compare. This process involves the following phases, three phases actually. Identify the closest way between the between two nodes having the same heading as the traffic sign. Compare the sign with the corresponding Waze attribute. If that attribute is missing or has a different value, probably we need to update the OSM. But what is the easiest way to do it? Our response is by means of one-click OSM edit. And we just arrived to the last step of our journey. In this step, we want to make map editing as easy as possible. For that, the end user will have the possibility to visually check the aggregated detections and map filter only those detections which are marked as being missed in OSM, and doing the corresponding actions to integrate those detections in OSM on the map. First step here will be to filter the JASM in JASM. Only new or changed detections. In our example, we split mid 40 group. We can also note that in the top right side of the window, of the filter window, we checked as being visible only aggregated detections. Also, it's important to see that we have detected a speed limit 40, and in OSM, there is a tag of max speed 35, which is different. This can be visualized on the right, top right quadrant in red. In this case, the end user will visually check the aggregated detection, taking a look also to the corresponding pictures. And if everything is okay, we'll integrate the new information in OSM by clicking on the new button, highlighting on the red ellipse. We call this functionality one-click OSM edit. So this will be the end result with the max speed attribute updated. This slide presents some details about preconditions, what JASM is doing, and the user steps. Also, here it's important to note that we should always start with the aggregated detections, not with raw detections, which were not aggregated before. I have just presented all the five steps required to reach our goal, presented when I started my speech. And for who is interested in architecture, I have two short slides presenting a simplified version of it. So, on the detection flow, which is the first flow which we are using, we can see that we have addressed concurrency, distribution, performance, and scalability, resulting in a microservices architecture. This slide presents the flow, starting with the component which is notified when a new trip arrives in OpenStreetCam, up to the moment when the position and detection are stored in the DB. We can also see on the pictures the component which were presented previously, like traffic signs detector, quality assessment component, OSM comparator, traffic sign positioner, and so on. The second architecture slide presents the flow we are using for aggregating detection. We are calculating those aggregation on geotiles. Also, we shared a part of our detection code, the community on GitHub being freely available. And we also had been running a competition for better traffic signs, links on the slide. JASM is also public. Soon we'll release a new version containing all visualization, including in my presentation. For the last part, I want to mention one of the last initiatives we had in order to make to better make use of the already collected sensor data from OpenStreetCam. And for that, we have built a machine learning model able to detect speed bumps. For instance, in the picture, we can see all detected speed bumps on a part of the city I'm living in the heart of Transylvania. We are already working on assessing road quality, detecting potholes, all of them using only sensor data, means no imagery here. Next step for us are integrating optical character recognition systems for signposts and additional panels, detecting point of interest, detecting lanes and road attributes, doing in-car processing, making use of LiDAR data mainly for better positioning of the traffic signs. We already started with some of them, and I will be happy to share with you the results on the next conference. If anybody interested, this is the technology stack we are using. Almost everything we have written is in Python with some little parts in Java. We can notice here a lot of machine learning libraries like TensorFlow, Keras, Caffe, TensorRT, scikit-learn. We are using ELK mainly for the audit and dashboarding. For our microservices architecture, we are using as a messaging system RabbitMQ. All components are Dockerized, and we are using Mesos in order to easily scale each and every component which was defined in architecture. And we have a continuous integration system with automatic builds in Jenkins. In the end, I want to thank you for your attention, and I would like to respond to any question from the room.